Welcome to the module of Project Baseline in Primavera P6. Get ready to understand the Primavera Project Baseline features in this video in detail. And let me start with discussion with the baseline in terms of construction project. Typically, on the onset of the construction project, the contractor have to submit an initial schedule to the owner. That initial schedule is approved by the owner, it becomes the project baseline. As the project moves forward, it becomes the basis for evaluating the progress of the project. But what is a baseline? Let us go to the ABC definition of the baseline schedule. A baseline schedule is a fixed project schedule that reflects all formally authorized scope and schedule changes against which the project performance is measured. Now, this statement seems quite complex. Let us try to crack down it into simple words. A schedule baseline is the approved, time-phased, and logically linked activities. Detailed interpretation of the project execution plan. If we take into this statement, we know that baseline schedule must be approved by the client, by the contractor, and the other stakeholders. Now the second is, work must be time phased. The work execution plan must be laid down with reference to some dates, some calendar, some working hours, deriving the start of the project date and end of the project date, by logically linking the entire work which has to be done to deliver the project. Now, along with this, a schedule may be resource loaded and it includes the entire project scope of the work. Now the question arises, a baseline schedule, is it necessary to be resources loaded? It is not mandatory to have a resource loaded or the cost loaded baseline schedule. But what is mandatory is that it include all the entire work of the project. In Primavera P6, baseline differ in the definition which we have just discussed. In Primavera P6, baseline is a special copy or a snapshot of the original schedule. When you prepare a baseline in Primavera, it takes a snapshot of the status at a specific point of time. And then it stores the snapshot such that you cannot edit it. We can say it is static. As you progressing your current schedule, you can overlay the baseline schedule to compare the performance to your baseline. A baseline in Primavera not only stores the dates and schedule, it also stores the cost and the resources associated with the schedule. With this additional data in Primavera, you can also compare your current resource usage with the planned baseline resource usage, and the spending to the baseline plan can be compared in Primavera P6. Primavera P6, you can easily evaluate whether your project is ahead or behind the baseline schedule. There's lot of flexibility with the P6 baseline. Let us create a baseline. So to create a baseline, first you have to copy the project for which you want to create the baseline. So right click on the project and then select the copy option. Again right click and click on the paste. Select all the tick marks of the project option and click on OK button. Then again WBS option will open. Again click on all the tick marks and then click on the OK button. For activity option also, click on all the buttons and then click on OK. So you can see now we have copied the original schedule. We will rename it as baseline 1. So sample project baseline 1 has been created in Primavera as another project by copying the original project. Now open the original project. Now here you can see we have a complete original project in which we have defined the activities, linkages, resources. Now we want to have a baseline schedule. Now to have a baseline schedule, let's follow this few simple steps. Now go to the project. Now when you click on the project, you will have two options: assign baseline and maintain baseline. First you have to click on the maintain baseline. To maintain baseline, once you click on the maintain baseline, then a dialog box will open. Now this will help you to maintain a baseline for your original program. So you need to click on the add button, and once you click on the add button, then the project which we copied and renamed as sample project baseline 1 can be selected. Now here you have two options: either to create this as a baseline, the project which is opened, or you can convert another project into a new baseline. So another project means the project which we copied. So we are selecting that and making it the baseline for the current project. So this is a very simple step. In this way we have maintained the baseline. But this is not sufficient. We have to assign this baseline to the project. Maintaining this baseline, we can maintain 100 baselines or maybe more than that. But we have to assign a particular baseline to the project. So now we are assigning this project baseline. Now select on the project baseline and select sample project baseline. Only those baseline which you have clicked on the managed baseline will be visible here. Now once you select this, then you will be having a three options: primary, secondary and tertiary. So at any given point of time in Primavera, you can have maximum of three baseline comparison on the project screen. So right now we have assigned only one. You can maintain n number of baseline, but you can assign three at a time. So we have assigned first one. Now to reflect this on screen, click right click on the Gantt chart and then click on the bar. So once you right click on the bar, then a dialog box will open. Here you have to select primary baseline. A lot of options to do the formatting is available here, which you can explore. So once you select the primary baseline, you can click on the OK button. Now as soon as you click on the OK button, you can see a baseline has been assigned to the project. This small yellow lines represent the baseline schedule, a baseline schedule which will not change with the time. When you update the activity, it will not shift, it will not change. This is fixed. Just to make it visible, I am increasing the width of the box of baseline schedule. So here I have changed the formatting. Now you can see this yellow boxes are the baseline schedule. It will not going to change when you're going to update the activity. Now just to make you understand that how we can utilize a baseline schedule, let us update one activity. So what will happen, let us observe in this video so that we can understand that how baseline is utilized by the planning engineer to track the project. So let us click on the first activity, that is cleaning, which has to be start on 4th Jan and have to be complete on 6th Jan as per the baseline. So this are original program as per which it has to be started on 4th. Let's click on the status in detail activity. It started on 4th Jan, but it delayed. Instead of 6th, let it completed on 13th. And we are clicking on OK 100% and then finished. So we have tracked this activity on the 13th Jan. So once you tracked this activity on 13th Jan, what we will do, we will reschedule the project so that we can find the impact of the delay. So on 13th Jan we'll put the data date so that the project will be updated as per the input given by us. Now here you can see, once we update it on 13th Jan, we can see that cleaning activity, which was 3-day activity, has been shifted in red color and have been changed. This blue line is the work which has been done, red is the critical path which is still scheduled, and yellow is the baseline. Now suppose on 30th Jan or maybe on some other day, we have again want to track the project. So we will again maintain a baseline. We'll create a copy of this current project and we will assign this as a secondary baseline. Now this secondary baseline have been assigned. So first revision was on 13th Jan when we updated cleaning activity, and the next revision is on 13th Jan when we added another baseline. And this will, just to show it, let us again click on the bars and click on the tick mark for secondary baseline. Now once you click on the secondary baseline, you can change the format as per your requirements. Just to make visible, I am just increasing the width of the boxes of the Gantt chart. Now here you can see, once I click it on the OK, again a yellow bar chart is reflecting on the screen. Now this represents the tertiary or the secondary baseline. Now once I again update any activity, then this program, this is a copy of a program on 20th Jan. So suppose on 30th Jan. So suppose first program was on 4th Jan, it's reflecting in yellow color. The next baseline is on 30th Jan, it's reflecting in this pink boxes which is shaded. Now on 20th Jan, I am updating the activity. So again there is a delay on the next activity, that is marking. I am again updating the activity. Now let us observe what will happen. The same process we have followed and have scheduled it. Now once I schedule it, I have to schedule it on the data date, which will be 20th Jan, the date which we are feeding the data. So on 20th Jan I am updating the schedule. Now you can see again my project has been delayed. My marking activity in blue has been completed, but baseline showing the delay with respect to baseline 1, baseline 2 and the original status.